Now, so, 在 earn 100,000 in a year, okay? Now, in every government, there will always... Now, do you want to read the income tax table based on this, or you want to read the income tax based on the lesser amount, the better?
More.
More the better, huh?
No, but
I see the income. Okay, let's do the table again. First 20,000, what's the income tax?
Zero.
How much do you pay?
Zero.
Okay. Now, so does it make sense for everyone in Singapore to aim for 20,000 a year?
No.
No, right? I hope to earn more, right?
Yeah.
But do you hope to pay more or pay less?
Pay less.
So you hope to earn a lot, but at the same time, you don't want to pay so much. But you cannot escape this table. So the government invents something called relief. Okay? Now what is relief all about? Relief is about minus this amount. Hold your question later. Minus this amount so that it becomes smaller. Now the smaller it becomes, the lesser tax you pay. Can follow? But I cannot say Zach look very handsome. I give him 90,000 relief. Can I add? Cannot. So the relief system works something like this. They want you to do something, but only when you do that something, then they will give you the relief. I give an example. Now all NS men will get a $3,000 of relief. What does it mean? If you serve NS, I give you a $3,000 off. Can you follow? Now, so if you skip NS, what happens? Then you don't have the relief. That's what it means. Okay? Now, another example. Singapore got low birth rate. Do I want more baby?
Yeah.
Yes. So if you give birth to more baby, I give you more relief. Can you follow? So for every baby you earn. For every baby that you give birth to, I give you a $5,000 off relief. Can follow? So what else do you want? What else do you think is the problem in Singapore? Is there many elderly or very few elderly?
Many,
right? Do you hope that the children of Singaporeans take care of their parents? Yes?
Should,
right? So maybe if you take care of your parents, I give you another 5,000 relief. So for example, for Zach, serve NS, have one baby, take care of parents. So how much relief does he entitled to? 13,000. So then I bring on the term called chargeable income. Now, chargeable income is equal to total income minus the relief. So this is a hope. Oh yeah, I forgot the most important one. Donation. Now if Zach donate 10,000 a year donation, this donation is entitled for relief as well. Okay? Now because of all these good things that he do, how much is he paying? So he will pay 100,000 minus everything add together lah. Can follow? All the relief add together. So how much is the remaining? 77,000 dollars. So this is a chargeable income. Now, how do I put the chargeable income into this table and calculate the tax I need to pay? So I will take the money, cut into different parts, okay, and put inside the table. Okay, so which column should I look? How I do is this. This table here, if I look again, first 30,000 is how much? 200, right? So actually, every two row is a category. I repeat, every two row is a category. So let's have some category. This is cat A, this is cat B, this is cat C, this is cat D, this is cat E. Do you hope to fall inside
A, B, C, D, E, which one do you hope to fall into?
A, B, C, D,
E. E, right? Wow, shiok, I earn a lot. But because I earn a lot, then I got to pay slightly more tax. Okay? So, let's look at Zach. Zach, what under which category?
C.
Do you know how to calculate the category?
Yes, C.
Who don't know, not sure? Okay, so let's look again. Now, cat A means I earn a maximum of how much? 30,000. Can follow? I repeat.
Cat A earn a max of 30,000. So which means cat A is between 0 to 30,000. What about cat B?
Wait, try. Cat B says first 30,000, then next 10,000. So in total how much? 40,000.
So cat B is from 0 to 40,000. Yan Ting again, try the next one. Okay, Yan Ting, I correct myself. So this one is between 30,000 to 40,000. I use K to help me. So Yan Ting, next one will be what? 40K to 80K. And then next one will be, I try myself, 80K to 120K. Who don't understand how I get the 120?
Okay, I just use 80 plus 40 to find the total. Can follow? Now the next one will be what?
120K to 160K. Okay, follow? Now, tell me Zach fall in which category?
C.
All agree?
Yeah.
Agree, yeah? So, how do I... Okay, so I'm going to focus my attention in C and try to understand how much
tax I read. So, I read. For the first 40K, Zach will pay how much? $550 tax. Can follow? For the next 40K, Zach will pay 7% of the tax. What's the maximum? 2,800. Can follow? Can follow? Now, say for example, Zach really earned 40,000. That means this will be $2,800, right? Now, what's the total tax he paid? Is it 2,800 or 2,800 plus 550? Plus. Now, do you notice that these two plus together give you the next bracket? Again, 550 plus 2,800 will give you the 3,350. Why? Because this is the first 80K. Can follow now? So if I earn the full 80K, I don't fall under cat C. I actually go to cat B. Then there's always a remaining amount. So let us focus in cat C.
So this is what you write. For first $40,000, tax equals to what? How much? 550. This one, no calculation. All can follow? Now, for remaining. Now, remaining, how much am I calculating?
Yes. Do you see that the 77000 now split into two parts? The first part is the 40K. The remaining part is how many percent?
7%.
Can follow? So you see, this...
Okay, so I do the math first, then I give you a mind map. So for the remaining 77000 minus 40K, which is equals to how much? 37,000. How much tax must I pay?
7%.
So I take 37,000 times 7%. What's the amount I get? Help me. Press the calculator. 2,590. So what's the total tax I paid?
550 plus 2,590.
Plus 2,590 equals to something like that. Can follow? Now I give you a summary of what happened. Now what happened is this. Zach earn 77000. Now you notice that it is broken out into two parts. The first part is 40,000. The second part is 37,000. So far clear?
Who lost on this? Nobody. Okay, not you. Okay, so what am I writing? How am I writing this? Now, this is broken into two parts. Why two parts? Because according to Cat C, I got to split up into first 40k and the remaining 40k. Clear? Yeah? Now, on the first 40k, my tax
is calculated as how much, Yinting?
On the first 40k, my tax is calculated on
550, very good. On the remaining 37k, it is calculated 7% times remaining.
Yinting, do you understand what I write here? Good. So 7% times remaining, remaining is the 37000. So the remaining tax will be 2590.
And this is how you calculated the tax every April of the year.
Can you follow? Yeah. Alright? So first year you work, there's no tax. Government give you free. Second year onwards will be tax. Yeah? Now, come back to this question. So young entrepreneur, Samuel. He paid a tax of 5700. Can he fall in the Cat A?
No.
No. Because Cat A, maximum tax is only $200. C. So he D. D means the maximum cap for the tax is 7K.
Ah, correct.
That means he fall under this category. Can follow? So how much did he earn? Do you need me to draw out the math or you understand and can try now? Who need me to draw out? Okay, so now you can try. Okay to try? Okay, can I stop the video here and then you try?
Okay. Who?